friends, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, my name is Ryan, and I hope you're having a magical day. Welcome to day two of our Orlando adventure. We've literally been up for the past 2 hours.
We woke up at 5:30.
Yeah, we woke up at 5:30, went to bed. Well, I went to bed apparently at 9:30, I don't remember. So we got our 7 hours, not feeling too bad. Oh, there's Sheree! Hello! Hi! Vlogception. But yeah, the plan for today is we are gonna go to Volcano Bay this morning. So Jimbo is very excited for that because that is his favorite water park of them all. I'm also excited too because I just love water park days.
Mm-hmm, me too.
And
such
yeah,
a good way to start the trip.
It is
such a good way, first day to be water park day. Yeah.
Yeah. I just love, especially for a 2 week trip. I think it's really important to just ease yourself into it. And water park days, they're not too strenuous. Mm-hmm. They're like a mixture of activity, but also chill. And then later on this afternoon, Michelle, Jimbo, and myself are heading to the Icon Park to do the Orlando Eye. And then tonight, we're going to head to Miller's. I think Shireen and Christopher are going to Disney Springs once we do the Orlando Eye, because they didn't want to do the wheel. So we're going to meet up in Miller's, maybe fill up on a lot of food, have food comas, and maybe a chicken cocktail, who knows. So this is our view this morning, and what a beautiful sunrise. Oh, I can't believe we get to wake up to this every day. A little pro tip for you, if you are wanting a view like that at reception, whenever you check in, they'll ask if you want a low floor or a high floor. Go for the high floor.
Floor 11.
Unless you don't like heights, then don't go for a high floor. But I don't like heights, but I love the view. So, yes, that is the plan for today. So I'm going to get up, get a quick shower, throw my rash vest on. And we're gonna go to Volcano Bay.
It might be an idea to throw some bottoms on too.
Well, I wanted to be a wee bit promiscuous today, you know. Get the goodies out. Oh, it's a bright day. We are heading over to the bus stop outside the lobby here. If you're staying at a Universal Resort, you get free transportation to City Walk and Volcano Bay. To Volcano Bay! We just arrived at Volcano Bay. Are we all excited?
Yeah.
We're gonna go find some lockers first to dump all our stuff in, and then we're gonna either find a lazy river, we're gonna find a wave pool, we're gonna go on the aquaculture, we're gonna find something to do, but I'm so excited to get back into the pools here. I got a pizza for lunch. What did you get?
Bacon cheeseburger.
Ooh. Yeah. I think we got the same, but no salad. Oh no, you can just take the salad off.
Mmm.
Happened. A flipping bird trying to poo all over my pizza. Why? Stop laughing.
Pretty much. Of course, a bird
will pee on my food. We've just left Volcano Bay. Have a good day.
Yes.
Well,
so good.
Yeah.
So much fun.
And definitely my favorite water park. The Tapu Tapu system is a little bit hard to get used to at first, but my opinion has totally changed since my first visit here. I really, really do enjoy the water park. So we're gonna head back to the resort now, and we're gonna go get showered and changed and cleaned up, because we're gonna go to the Icon Park and do the Orlando Eye. Yay! They're chill, but it still makes you tired.
Yep.
But we have to persevere. We have to go to the Orlando Eye and Millard. We need to do this. Is anyone still feeling jet lagged at all? I don't feel too bad. I feel a little bit tired, but I think it's mainly because of the water park today than
actual
jet lag.
I'm definitely
jet lag.
Water park's tired.
Yay! We're on our way to the Icon Park to do the Orlando Wheel. We're just taking a wee leisurely stroll down I Drive as we do it, because why not? Well, the weather is lovely, the sun is out, we're not in a rush to be anywhere. So, yeah.
3.5 minutes ago, my hair was wet, now my hair is dry.
It's dry! Exactly! There are many, many perks to it, having a nice wee walk. And also, it's very quiet walking.
Yeah.
Many more people apparently like to drive here. But, yes, I'm very excited for the wheel, something I've never done before.
Which is crazy to find something that this one
has
never
done yet. I know, right? I'm excited for it. Apparently, it's similar to the London Eye, if you've ever been on the London Eye before.
Nope.
I
went on the Amsterdam Eye when it was in Amsterdam. Is that the same thing?
Rubbly?
I don't know. I'll let you know.
It apparently takes like half an hour to get around it, to do like a full loop. So, and apparently the views are absolutely incredible. So,
yeah,
so I'm really excited to A, be on it, and B, show you guys what it's all about. The tickets I got, so I bought my tickets from Florida Tix. At the time, they were £19. And it covered 14 days, so we could go anytime within a 14-day.
So we can go multiple times, or we one trip?
I think one trip.
Ah, okay.
I think.
Ah, okay.
But you could go like anytime.
Oh, that's good.
Whereas I think if you just rock up at the Icon Park looking to get on the wheel, it's something like $60.
Excuse me?
Yes.
What? We have more flexibility, and we paid a third of the price.
So pro tip for you, if you are coming from the UK, or actually just anywhere in general, book your tickets in advance, because you will save yourself a lot of money.
Yeah.
There's Ripley, believe it or not. If you watch my 2018 series, we went in there. It's a great wee attraction if you're looking for to kill a few hours. So there is the Star Flyer. Absolutely not. We're here.
He stand clear of the closing doors.
Whee! I just get in this room. Maybe that's my height.
I know. You hear height?
I
hear height too. Yeah, I don't know how that will work. Although, I do like the London Eye, so like, this should be grand too. So if you are thinking of coming on the Orlando Eye, they do have aircon in here.
Please stand clear of the closing doors.
Excuse me, rude woman, I'm trying to vlog here.
Arrived in Florida, chasing dreams of eternal youth and expanded empire. These explorers found the temperate climate right
there
from growing
citrus
and planted the region's first orange trees. Word of La Florida's abundance soon spread, driving more European colonization. By the early 1800s, few settlers had taken the marshy Central Florida wilderness that was then part of Mosquito County. Besides a few lawless outposts and a Seminole tribe reservation, the area was largely unpopulated until 1845,
with
the U.S. Army established near modern-day downtown Orlando.
and it's pretty cool, but I'm like...
there's a Union Jack on top of
United Ireland and Starfire.
No, oh no, no.
Just say, right, if you were all that right now, you'd be on this side.
But you would be a lot less safe.
I am.
Over there, there's Universal.
Congratulations! You are coming in the sky like a true Orlando dreamer from Florida.
That's better.
There's Universal over there. Look, there for a short. If you look over there, that is the built site for Epic Universe and Universal Park. And I think it's going to be quite epic from the size of it. Over there is SeaWorld and Aquatica.
Do you know something?
So if you're like me, I do not like heights. You can still do this attraction, but it's not too bad. It's very, very high, and my hands are very, very clammy. We're going very slow. It feels sturdy, it feels safe. It's grand, and like, if you've watched any of my past vlog series in Orlando, you'll know I hate heights and I cannot do them. But this is okay, this is doable. So if you're like me and you have a fear of heights, you'll be good. No.
Offers a mix of attractions, restaurants, and shopping that's a cut above the usual.
No, no.
Thrills to
not today, Steven.
Oh,
Jimbo.
And they're very colorful.
You wanted a hat? Jimbo. You wanted a hat?
So the icon wheel was really, really good. We really enjoyed ourselves. Also, every time a party's been in the capsule, an attendant comes in and quickly sanitizes the railings and stuff. If you care about that sort of thing. So we are currently heading to Ben and Jerry because this one wants an ice cream.
Yeah, I want something cool.
Something cool. And something to treat yourself with. There's Miller's, that's where we're going for dinner tonight.
This is only literally across the road from the room.
They all do that. So yeah, I don't get it. But at least the option's there for if you want the meat, do you know what I mean?
If you want to get the chicken parmesan thing.
The singers are good.
They are good. Finger button, man. So how was your first trip to Miller's Ale House?
Oh, so
really
nice. Good. Is that your first one?
Yeah. It's our first one. She was a Miller's Ale House
beef
version.
Chicken parmesan fettuccine.
Really good.
Oh, so good. I miss pasta. I love pasta. It was good.
For context, Sherry, Michelle has been on the keto diet for a few years, so
I haven't had pasta in 3 years.
Any carbs whatsoever. And what did you get, Cherie?
I got vegetarian Alfredo. It's delicious.
Is it good?
Yeah, you can't go wrong with a good bit of pasta and a wee slice of garlic bread on the side.
Oh, it looked good.
Pure bliss.
And also, again, really cheap. My finger mountain milk cost $15. So then by the time you add tax and a tip, like altogether, I paid $25 towards the bill.
Mm-hmm.
So for like a dinner, but it filled my stomach.
It's so good.
It's a really good show. Yeah. So if you're in the Orlando area, go to Miller's Ale House, make time for it because it's good food, cheap food, and more importantly, you'll have a food baby.
More like a wee
vent in a sink.
Because
there's like a woman, there's like one. It looks really cool at night, but still wouldn't want to pee on it.
You know what night it would work?
Imagine being out after like a full dinner. No, thank you. That is us back at the resort. Changed into our jam jams for the night and we're absolutely shattered. It's like, just after half 11. So It's been a very long day. Quick recap, the Volcano Bay this morning. I'm sorry I didn't film too much, but I couldn't be bothered going back and forth to get my GoPro every time we did like a different attraction or a different slide. Just to be told either A, put away and whatnot. Nah, that wasn't happening. But we had a great day at Volcano Bay. It was a lovely wee morning. We got on everything that we wanted to, and we do have another day there planned as well, so we can do other slides that we didn't get done today, plus the ones that we really enjoyed today. The Orlando Eye, I would thoroughly recommend going to if you have time in your trip. Would you recommend?
100%. Yeah. It was very good.
It was really good.
Yeah, it was well worth the money.
Yeah, like. And I said before, we only paid £19 compared to like $60 at the gate. So once again, buy your ticket before you leave the UK. Especially if you're coming from the UK, buy your ticket beforehand from like the Florida Ticks or Orlando Attractions or any of those ticket sites. I'm not sponsored in any way, but just go to them, buy your ticket beforehand, because you'll save a little bit of money doing it that way instead of buying your tickets here. My voice is starting to go because I think I've screamed far too much this morning.
Yeah.
Holy moly. And it'll probably be the same tomorrow because I'm sure we'll be doing a lot of screaming as we're heading to Universal Studios. But we're obviously with our early entry tomorrow, we're going to Islands of Adventure. So we're going to try and get on Hagrid's and Velocicoaster in the morning. And even if we don't get them both done in the morning, we're going to be doing them throughout the day anyway. And I'm just really excited to get back to Universal. It's my favourite theme park out of all the theme parks here in Orlando. I love Universal so much, and I'm excited to get back. It's going to be such a fun day tomorrow. Favourite attraction that you're looking forward to?
What are we doing tomorrow? Are Universal? Probably the Hulk. Rip Ride Rocket.
Ooh.
I'm going to say the Hulk.
The Hulk. Mm. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the Hulk too. So yes, tomorrow will be a fun day. So on that note, I'm going to end the vlog here because we are tired. We're going to go to bed. We have a very early wake up tomorrow morning. So yeah, we need to go get some sleep, and Big Ryan needs to rest his voice for more screaming. Woohoo! So on that note, like the video if you enjoyed it, subscribe to the All Our Future Adventures. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all have a magical day wherever you may be, and we will see you next time. Bye!